Welcome to Savvy IT Solutions. In the last video, we are discussing about else if, ladder, syntax, exactly where we are using, and syntax, and flowchart. And two examples are discussed. In this video, we are discussing two more examples of else if ladder in detail. Okay, so initially, we are discussing about else if ladder. Okay, so now we are discussing the syntax. If the condition 1 is true, then statement 1 will be executed. If condition 1 is false, then we are checking condition 2. If this condition 2 is true, then statement 2 will be executed. If the condition 2 is false, then condition 3 will be checked. If this condition 3 is true, then statement 3 will be executed. If it is false, then so on, the else part will be executed at the end and the statement 4 will be executed. So this is simply the meaning of the syntax of else if ladder. Now what I am doing is I am also draw a flow chart. So here condition 1 is true, then statements 1 no. Again we need to check one more condition, that is condition 2. This is true, then statements 2, that is false, then no. And again we need to check one more condition 3, statements 3, no, it ends to statements 4. Okay, all are connected and come out of the link. This is the flowchart related to else if ladder. So now already we discussed else if build program as well as class obtained in the previous video. Now we are learning print the grade of a student. Here we are not taking all the subjects, only we are taking one subject for consideration. Okay, so initially I will make the table. Based on the table I will write the code. So marks grade. In the later videos we will discuss about SGPA program. Now on that we are also use points, but here the points are not at all useful in this concept, so that I am ignoring that point here. Okay, so now marks greater than equal to 85 O grade, in between 75 to 85 A, in between 65 to 75 B, in between 55 to 65 C, in between 45 to 55 D, in between 40 to 45 E, in between less than 40 F. So based on this data we need to write a program. So we take the variable as M. If M greater than equal to 85, printf O, else if m greater than equal to 75, printf a else if m greater than equal to 65, printf b else if m greater than equal to 55, printf c else if m greater than equal to 45, printf d else if m greater than equal to 40, printf e. Finally else print f. This is the way we are representing a grade of a subject in a subject for a student. So the next one is, write a C program to find the roots of the quadratic equation. So when we need to find, already you know that quadratic equation is nothing but ax square plus bx plus c is equal to 0, where a not equal to 0. Whenever a not equal to 0, then only it will be a quadratic equation. So that after this we need to find the discriminant or d is equal to b square minus 4ac. If this d is equivalent to 0, then root 1 minute. Roots are real and equal. If d is greater than 0, roots are real and unequal. And if d is less than 0, imaginary. Okay. Now based on this information, I will write in a simpler way, but I'm not finding the root values here. But while I am explaining practically, definitely I will calculate the root values also. Okay. So simply, initially we need to read the values of a, b and c. Value of a is nothing but coefficient of x square, b is nothing but coefficient of x, and c is the constant. So if we need to check a not equal to 0, then only the process will start. Otherwise this process will not be going on. Okay. So here what I need to do, d is equal to b into b minus 4 into a into c. After this we need to check if d equal to 0. Here I am printing the only nature of the roots, but when I am explaining practically, I will also mention the values of the roots. Print the values of the roots. Roots are PL and equal, else if D greater than 0, printf roots are real and unequal. So finally it is less than 0, so printf roots are imaginary. So here again else printf the equation is linear, not quadratic. If a is equal to 0, this part will become 0, so that bx plus c is a linear equation. That's why it is not quadratic equation. So in the next video onwards, we need to learn in a practically. So these four programs are learned in a practically. Already we discussed one video theoretically, and this is the second video theoretically. Four programs will be discussed in four sequential videos. Thank you.